We all know the basic outline for Disney's Cinderella. It implies that a woman must meet a man in order to achieve her happily ever after. But trends show that modern day females do not want that for their lives. It's evident in films such as The Cheetah Girls by Disney, where Gabriella and her friends sing a song about their ideal Cinderella. Originally, the need for marriage rested on two pillars, family and stability. However, the New York Times is showing that these two pillars are being challenged. More women are going to pursue their bachelor's and master's degrees before they settle down and pursue committed relationships. For this reason, there are more single ladies now than ever before.
Different to be married. It really does. And it feels good, doesn't it?
Feels great.
And how long were you and Jay-Z together before you got married?
Oh gosh, listen to me. I'm about to start yapping. Yeah. We've been together a long time. It's been about 7 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
7 years. But it does feel different, doesn't it?
Feels great.
I really love it. So 7 years, and was it something that y'all talked about, or you just all of a sudden decided let's do it?
I mean, it's different for everyone. I was really young. I'm only 27. Mm-hmm. So I was really young, and you know, I feel like it's important for women and men to have their goals in their own life before they can can complete someone else. So,
right.
You know, we took our time.
He must have been pushing on getting married to lock you up, though. He must have been saying, come on, I know you're young, but let's just do it. He must have been, like, really pushing to, you know, come on.
As you can see, Beyonce is confident in herself as an individual. She doesn't believe she needs a man to walk into her happily ever after. But what is the price of being an independent woman? How much is a power couple worth?
Question, tell me what you think about me. I buy my own diamonds and I buy my own rings. Only ring your celly when I'm feeling lonely. When it's all over, please get up and leave. Question, tell me how you feel about this. Try to control me, boy, you get dismissed. Pay my own condo and I pay my own bills. Always 50-50 in relationships.
At first, I have to admit, I was a little confused about the connection between Beyonce's fairy tale marriage and her prenuptial agreement. So I spoke to divorce attorney Aaron Thomas. He has handled similar cases to Beyonce's and was able to shed some light on the situation.
There's the debate that if you're going to marry someone, then there should not be a need for a prenuptial agreement because it's the whole, if you love them, it doesn't matter about the money. But then there's like a reverse thing where if you love me, you won't just want my money. So what is your opinion on that? Why do people get prenuptial agreements?
My opinion on that is I don't think that by buying insurance, car insurance, that you are going into it with the expectation of having a wreck. And just because you drive safely doesn't mean you won't have one. Because, you know, for the same reasons that I think that going into a marriage, everything is not in your control. There are two people that are part of that contract. You know, you're not just starting a relationship and ending a relationship. You're entering into a financial bond that has real complications, you know, has real consequences based on the laws of the state that you're in.
Photo shoot fresh, looking like wealth. I'm about to call a paparazzi on myself.
Okay. Now, let's talk about Beyonce and Jay-Z specifically. It's said that Beyonce is worth about $300 million and Jay-Z's about $475 million. Like, with such large fortunes, why would they need a prenuptial agreement? Like, it seems like they don't need any more money in case they split. So why have one if you're already rich?
Beat that block. Now I bees the block.
Let me upgrade.
I think that probably in their situation, they both have so many assets and things that could get drug into court and exposed to the entire public, that it would be better for them to just determine what's going to happen at the end of their marriage ahead of time in terms of finances. Because what you do when you get married, and a lot of people don't realize this, is you give the state that you live in the permission to subpoena documents that otherwise would be private under any other circumstances. Your credit card bills, every document for the companies that you own, how they're formed, internal documents, your phone bills, all of those can be subpoenaed at the end of a divorce. And if you own a lot of companies and that's a lot of information, and that's something that I don't think a lot of parties probably want to go through. Yeah. At the end of their marriage, and if you have that much money and you can go ahead and determine ahead of time and not, you know, subject yourself to that at the end of the marriage, then you'd be for the best of both parties, really.
So it's like the state is even seeing that you're no longer your own individual, but you're, like, joint with this other person.
Right, and that's exactly the difference between marriage just being love and marriage being all these other things, is if you get a marriage certificate, you didn't just enter a love contract. Otherwise, you could just kiss and say, I'm going to spend the rest of my life with you. When you get married, you get an actual legal document, and that has legal consequences, whether you like it or not.
In the prenuptial agreement for Beyonce and Jay-Z, she's also going to receive about $5 million per child that she has in that marriage. Why would she be paid for having children?
Probably a reduction of her earning potential.
Okay.
A couple years off the market. I mean, she's having a child, having a newborn, and being pregnant will probably take money out of her pocket.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's a weird way to look at it. But, you know, she's in her prime, in her career, and she's also in the prime time for her to have children biologically. So, maybe that's, you know, compensation for them, you know, going into this contract. But it also sounds like Beyonce may have had a little more leverage with her attorneys in this in this deal.
Final, let me upgrade you, grade you. Final, let me upgrade you, grade you. Let me upgrade you, grade you. Final, let me upgrade you.
Beyonce is a prime example of what women want today. They want to be fulfilled themselves before entering into a relationship. They don't want to rely on Prince Charming to come and sweep them off their feet. It's like happily ever after begins even before a man steps into the picture. And maybe Beyonce was right. Maybe girls really do run the world.